Sasha stepped on a table, had a speech, and I was standing about 5 feet from him. And again, I was begging God, let me survive. And he said the last words. But they said, remember what he said in the film? This is what I did remember, I told him. And he said, whoever will survive, his duty is to tell the world what's happened here. And I promised me, God, if you will let me survive, I will never relax telling. And suddenly, we had a shot from far away. I didn't see this, but later I find out that a German discovered a dead body of his comrade, and he sounded alarm, but it was too late for them, anyway.
But how many do you think were still alive? How many Germans?
How many Germans? About 12 from Sobibor.
Okay.
Anyway, so we realized something happened. So the plan was a little bit, didn't work at that point because we planned to march out. So we realized something wrong. So he stepped on the table and had the speech, Sasha. And suddenly somebody started to yell, hurrah! First a single voice. Somebody probably wasn't able to stand it any more detention because Sasha was still speaking. When he said, hurrah, and everybody picked it up, hurrah, hurrah. And we did run to the gate. I did run to the gate, and I remember a Nazi did come driving in with a bike. He was immediately thrown for the bike, killed, the weapon taken away. And I was running with the main group to the main gate, and I remember Frenzel shot in Katus with a machine gun. I remember another Nazi with his back against the canteen. They have a canteen. I shot him with a pistol while he was backing up. And as he hear a friend fall here, there, hear the whistle of the bullets. So I backed up and started to run back. And at that point, I don't remember what's happened. But the next thing I remember, I did find myself in a corridor. You see, there were three barbed wires running around Sobibor and a minefield. The first two barbed wires were fairly close, but between the second and the third last barbed wire, there was a hallway, a guard for the Ukrainians with the dogs, for the guards. By that time, the Ukrainians did escape, being afraid. So I find myself, probably I went into the gate where the Ukrainian guards went in. I find myself in this hallway, and I realize, luckily I have two barbed wires behind me, barbed wire fences, on the one front fence, but in the hand I had only a knife. I remember there was inscription Kusher Shel Paisa, probably
Pearl,
probably was a rabbi's knife because I find it in the luggage. And what could I do with the knife? I stood in the front of the fence, barbed wire fence. Sasha was nearby, the leader of the world, with a pistol. He can do much either. And was Shloma with a rifle. I remember him shooting. More and more people did come, and finally a guy did come with an axe and start to cut a hole in the fences, and people start to go through the hole. But more and more people did come in, and from the guards, the guards which were from the towers, the guards which were unable to reach, start to shot, and people were waiting in the line, they start to climb the fence. And while I was, and that time I thought this is the worst thing could happen. At a time stuck, I will be in Sobibor because the moment I went through this hole, at that point, the fence onto the heaviness of the bodies of the people climbing collapsed and pinned me down. Now I realized that this was my luck because while laying onto the fence, people stepping over me, I've seen bodies taken apart by the mines. And later when everybody went through, I did try to climb out and wasn't able because the barbs that embedded in my cord. And luckily I had a leather cord because I picked it up from the storerooms and didn't go too deep, but I did slid out from this leather cord and left the cord onto the barbed wires and I was running. And I was probably the last one. I did fall down a couple times, I remember, on the field. I thought I'm hit, but I did get up and run it until I reached the forest.